Hi, fourth grade. First, I want to congratulate you and tell you what a great job you did this year. I really enjoyed working with you, and I miss you a lot. I wish we could be together on campus. I want you to know how proud I am of all of your hard work this year. And you did such a great job of welcoming in new friends into the fourth grade class and a new fourth grade teacher. I know that these strengths and all the many wonderful things about you will help you find lots of new friends as you go on into middle school and upper school. I can't wait to learn about all the things that you accomplished, and I'm hoping you'll come back and see us in Beasley a lot. Again, congratulations. I'm gonna miss you a lot, and I can't wait to celebrate with you in person as soon as we can be back together on campus.
Oh, sorry, fourth graders. Just hanging out here on a mountain someplace. I was asked to give some advice to you, and to be honest, I feel like you guys are more likely to give me advice since I've learned so much more from you this year than I could have ever imagined. But I do want to leave you with seven quick thoughts from Mr. Brennan to you as you go through MICDS. Number one, as you see me here playing my ukulele or little guitar, whatever it is, don't be afraid of making a fool of yourself. Wear a silly hat. This one I got in Peru. It's awfully silly. But don't be afraid of making a fool of yourself, okay? Laugh at yourself. Have that as a really strong ability. It'll take you far places in the world, okay? Number two, I want you to find a solution, not an excuse. It is so easy to find a solution. So easy to find an excuse for things. It is so much harder to find a solution for it. So actively look for things rather than complaining, I couldn't do this, I couldn't do that. Figure out how you're gonna be able to do that thing. Number three, if you're not having fun at recess, why are you still playing that game? Okay, it goes for a lot of things. You're going out to shoot baskets and you feel like someone's cheating and you feel like you're getting all upset about it. Stop playing. There's other things to do. Go find that other thing. Go find the person that's having the same sort of bad experience as you are and go do something together with them. I'd say number four, look for opportunities to help before you're asked to help. Sure, cafeteria is a good example of that, but I remember a student this year who, at the end of the day, would constantly stay after to clean up the room, lift things that were didn't belong to her. And I tell you this only because that's looking for opportunities to help without me explicitly asking to help. Do that. Be the student that walks down the hallways in the morning and picks up the things that are lost and found items and puts them away. Close somebody's locker if it's open and their stuff is out. Let someone know, hey, I saw your windbreaker, it's down in the lost and found. Look for opportunities to help before you're asked to help. Number five, horizon tide lifts all boats. I know I said that to you quite often this year. But cheer on your classmates, cheer on your friends, cheer on your enemies, cheer on everybody, because the more you cheer them on, that lifts up all of you guys together, okay? A rising tide lifts all boats. You're all going to be wildly successful, I have no doubt about that. But I would love it if you're wildly successful, and you can credit all of the people around you that helped you with that success as well. Number six, is that right? Number six, when you find yourself starting to argue with someone, ask yourself, is it more important to win the argument or win the friend? By that, just don't argue about little stuff, okay? If it's getting in the way of your friendship with someone, take a step backward. Be like, we don't need to argue about this, okay? Preserve the friendship over winning the point. There's no joy in just winning the point. And I think finally, the last bit of advice I would give you is do not suffer from failures of kindness. And by that, I mean always look for opportunities to be kind. It's easy to be kind. It's harder, of course, and I've told you this year as well, to be kinder. Being kinder means that you have to inconvenience yourself a little bit. So I challenge you to not suffer from failures to be kinder. Okay? Kind is great. Kinder is better. Come back and visit me next year, please. I will give you marshmallows, or I won't give you marshmallows, you know. It didn't always happen with the fifth graders this year. But I will always, always, always be completely ecstatic to see you. Even when I seem maybe a little crabby chasing your room because the graders are trying to do their work, I still will be ecstatic to see you. Best of luck with everything. You guys absolutely rocked it this year, and I am so looking forward to seeing how you're going to grow and do awesome things for MICDS and for our world. Good job.
fourth grade, class of 2028. Congratulations to each one of you. The current school year is certainly not ending in the way we would have anticipated, but I commend you all for your great effort and the way that you have stuck to it, and you've been great problem solvers to figure out how to do school in this new distance learning environment. I just want to say that I really appreciate getting to know each of you even a little bit better this year during fourth grade lunch groups. That was definitely a highlight of my year, and I hope that you enjoyed that time as much as I have. I've also really enjoyed the time that I've spent with you all in years past. Some of you I've known for 6 years now, which is quite a long time, and I've seen many positive changes and growth over time in each one of you, and I'm just so proud of you all. Take care. I wish you the best. Have a wonderful summer, and I know that you will do fabulous work next year in fifth grade. Bye-bye.
Hi, Beasley musicians. I look back over our years together and I think of all the fun we've had in music class and chorus. Think about things like the second grade opera and winter programs and just the joy of making music together. I wish you all the best as you head towards middle school and try to make a time every day to put a little music in your life. Best of luck to you.
Great, this has been an interesting year for you guys. The good news is I know that you're very creative and very resilient. I know you're resilient because you have negotiated Zoom meetings and Seesaw postings and various online activities and done a great job. I know you're creative because I saw some amazing inventions before spring break. So as you move on to middle school, I have four pieces of advice. Number one, be willing to work with others. Number two, be willing to make new friends. Number three, be willing to ask questions when you don't understand something. And number four, and maybe the most important, always label your numbers. Or, as I like to say in class, no naked numbers. Good luck, fourth grade. I'll probably see you in the hallways as I'm subbing next year. Have a great summer.
Congratulations, fourth grade. You have made it through elementary school and you are on your way to middle school. I have a feeling that your fourth grade year is going to be one that you will never forget, but hopefully you remember it just as much for how much you grew and you changed and you learned as for how it ended. My most important piece of advice for you for next year is to be kind. Be kind to yourself and to others. Remember, you learn by making mistakes, and you will make mistakes, so give yourself room to do that, and give your friends room to do that too. And always, always remember that if you need us, your fourth grade teachers are just down the hall, and we would love to see you and hear how you're doing. Congratulations.
Congratulations, fourth grade. Good luck in middle school.
Hi, fourth graders. Congratulations on moving on to middle school. It's super exciting. So the first thing I want to say is that you guys will always hold a special place in my heart because you're my first class at MICDS, and you guys taught me what it means to teach at a school that feels like family. And the second thing I'd like to do is offer you a little advice for your future. The first piece of advice is my famous quote, "Rushing is the enemy of accuracy," because I believe in my soul that if you slow down, try your best, check over your work, and proofread, you'll be all right. And my second piece of advice is, of course, to read. I know I didn't convince all of you that reading is the best thing on earth, but hopefully you at least learn to love one story or one book or one shared experience, or at least believe that I love reading because I do. And the more you read, the more you learn to love it. So read and don't rush, and good luck. And be sure to say hi to me next year in the hall.
Hello, Beasley students in fourth grade. It's Mr. Lohr here. I want to say congratulations on your graduation out of the Beasley School and on into the middle school in the fifth grade. You've been a wonderful group to work with, some very talented children in the class, and all of you have been so fun to be around and to get to know. And I want to wish you the best as you go into the middle school. And I really hope that next year when you're in fifth grade, you might take some time to come by and stick your nose in the gym and say hello to us. Ms. O and I are always glad to see you. Good luck and have a wonderful summer.
Hi, fourth grade friends. I'm so sorry that we can't be together to celebrate your graduation from Beasley, but I want you to know how proud I am of each and every one of you. You worked so hard over your last several years, and you have accomplished so much. I hope when you look back on your time in SK, a big smile comes to your face. I know it does for me. We had a lot of fun together. We had mystery readers, we played and crafted and cooked together in SK Cafe. We went on field trips to the theater and the zoo. We dressed up in really silly outfits for our Dr. Seuss dress-up days. We got to watch birds and ladybugs grow and develop in our classrooms. It really was a lot of fun. I have enjoyed my time with you so much. I wish you the best of luck in middle school. Please don't forget to stop by and say hello. Bye, friends.
Congratulations, class of 2028. I have been thinking of you all as we've all been at home. I miss having you as my rambassadors. You've been just wonderful leaders for our lower school and helping me with all our visitors this year. So I just want to say thank you. Congratulations. And wherever you go and whatever you do, I know you'll all be doing your best. We'll see you in fifth grade on the other side of the hallway.
Hi, fourth graders, soon to be fifth graders. I just wanted to send a little video to say congratulations to each and every one of you. We're very proud of all of your hard work through your Beasley years, especially in second grade. I wish you the best of luck in middle school, and I know each of you will do great. One of my favorite memories from your class being in second grade was that was the first year we did swimming as a unit in PE, and you were the first class to swim in the new pool. And I can still picture each and every one of you doing your floating, that was just something I really enjoyed watching. So do your best in middle school, be a good friend, be a good listener, all the things that you've worked on in Beasley, and you're ready, be confident, you're prepared, come back anytime, we'll miss you, please say hello, and be good. Have fun.
Hi, fourth graders. I just wanted to tell you I miss you so much. You guys have done an amazing job under these circumstances. We're so, so proud of you. We're super excited to see all of the great things that you're going to do next year in middle school. And please don't forget that we are right down the hall from you. Please come stop in, say hi. If you need anything, we are always here for you. We love you, and we are so, so proud of you. And I hope you have a great summer and enjoy the rest of the school year together.
Congratulations, fourth grade. I'm so proud of you all for completing your chapter at MICDS in Beasley. Good luck next year in the middle school, and don't forget where you came from. Come visit us in the lower school. Congratulations.
Hi, fourth grade. Congratulations on graduating from Beasley. We're very proud of you. I had the pleasure and was lucky enough to teach many of you for 2 years, once in SK and then again in second. So I created a short slideshow to remind you of some of my favorite memories with you. If you were here in SK, one of the things that we did was we counted the number of days of school, and then on the 100th day of school, we had a big celebration, and we had a surprise visit from a superhero named Zero the Hero. I'm not sure if you remember this, but Zero the Hero came into our room, and many of you were not convinced that he was actually a superhero. People were screaming, "It's just a man! He's just a man with the cape!" But we tried to convince you otherwise, that it was actually a superhero named Zero the Hero. And but actually it was just a man, and that man was my husband, Mr. Kroushar. So that was a extra hilarious day in SK for me. In second grade, many of my favorite memories have to do with PBL. We had so much fun on our surprise field trip to all of our landmarks that we spent so much time researching. And then we also were able to take some time to learn about the Winter Olympics. And our client was Mr. Patsky. He was the U.S. men's curling coach. So we remember we created this class torch, and we sent it to him, and he took it to Pyeongchang with him and took pictures all over Pyeongchang with our torch. And then his team actually won gold that year. So that was extra special to be a part of and to have that connection with him. Those are just a couple of my favorite memories with you guys, but there are very many more. Congratulations again. Good luck in middle school next year. Work hard, try your best, and don't forget to visit us in Beasley because we're going to miss you.
Hello, fourth grade students. Miss Badra here. I can't believe you're already going to fifth grade. I'm so excited for you. One of my favorite memories with you guys is actually when I met you when you were in third grade, and that was my first year at MICDS. That was one of the best years I've ever had, and I'm so thankful it was with you guys. One word of advice I would give you is to always be yourself, because you guys are amazing, talented, wonderful students, and I wouldn't want you to be anybody else but yourself. And I want you to always have a positive outlook on life, because that's going to get you very far. So thank you guys for giving me one of the best years of my life at MICDS, and I'm so thankful that I got to meet you. All right, you guys have a wonderful summer, and I hope to see you guys very, very soon. Bye.
Hello, my fourth grade friends. Mrs. Heineman here. A big congratulations to you on completing your fourth grade year. Some words of advice as you make your way to the middle school. First, be kind. Not just be kind to others, but be kind to yourself as you make this big shift to the middle school. You may hit some bumps in the road, you may feel a bit challenged, overwhelmed, but let me just say, everything's gonna be okay. You're gonna love middle school, so just remember to be kind to yourself. Also, remember to be courageous. Take risks, try new things, explore your skills and talents. You're gonna have even more opportunities once you're in the middle school. So be courageous and challenge yourself. And then last, but certainly not least, I would encourage you to be curious. Continue to be a curious learner, seeking information, asking good questions, so that you feel like a strong, powerful learner. Okay, my friends, I cannot wait to have you in the Freeman Theater as fifth graders. It's going to be a really exciting year, and it's an exciting time for you. Enjoy your summer, and a big congratulations. Bye-bye.
Hi, fourth grade. I want to tell you a short story about your class when you were in senior kindergarten here. That's the same year that my son moved to fifth grade and was no longer a student in lower school. He's the last of my four children, and I had taught all of them in lower school. I thought maybe when he went to fifth grade, I should be done teaching. And then I joined you at lunch and found out how much you made me laugh. You made disastrous messes at the lunchroom, and I joined you over and over again and found out very swiftly that there was something new and fun and enjoyable to learn from you every day, and you made me want to keep teaching here and to stay in Beasley. And it's no wonder that I've joined you for lunch almost every school day since senior kindergarten. You are the people who make me want to come to school and be there. As friends have left your class, I've been sad to see them go. And as new people have joined your class each year, I've been thrilled to see new faces join your community of fourth grade friends. And now, I think I'll be sad again to see you go to fifth grade, but I wish you the best. And I hope that I'll still get to see you, that you'll come by and say hi to me in the halls. And I'll probably sneak over to the middle school cafeteria and eat lunch there as often as I can. And I will be looking for you and hoping that you'll say hi to me.
Congratulations, fourth graders. Best wishes as you travel on to middle school. Keep up the good work and come back and see us sometime.
Hi, fourth grade. I know that this is a unique time that we are celebrating you moving on to fifth grade and to middle school. So here is a little bit of advice I'd like to share with you. Life is the art of drawing without an eraser. There will be times that you will make a mistake, but you do not want to erase these mistakes. You will want to learn and grow from the moment. Find the beautiful oops in difficult situations, and live life with a lot of oomph. Art can teach you a lot about life experiences. You just have to take time to look around and find the beauty and the kindness around you. I can't wait to see what amazing things you will do. Congratulations, fourth grade.
Hi, fourth graders. I want to congratulate you on your graduation to fifth grade. Super proud of you and love getting to know you at lunch and recess and in the hallways. I'm sure going to miss you at Beasley. Can't wait to see you in the hallways next year. I hope you have a good summer and I look forward to seeing you in the fall. Congratulations.
Hola, chicos y chicas. ¿Cómo están? I miss you so much, guys. What a different school year for you in fourth grade. Next year, you will be in fifth grade, and I wish each of you the best in middle school. Please continue enjoying learning and do your best in each class, guys. Remember that if middle school gets harder, you don't give up. Just practice and work from that. Guys, get also next year. Set aside time to just relax, have fun, dance, read. Continue building wonderful memories with your friends and with the new friends who are coming in middle school. Take care of each other and be kind to each other. And guys, don't forget to come and visit your previous teachers in Beasley. We love you and we take care of you. If you need something in Spanish or if I can help you in something, come and visit me. I will be always happy to see each of you and to help you in anything that I can. Remember that, okay? Les quiero mucho. Suerte. Good luck, guys. Good luck. Abrazos. Hugs to all of you. Adios.
Hi, fourth graders. I just want to say congratulations, and my advice for you is to always work hard, treat others well, be kind, and keep that smile on your face. Good luck in middle school. Hope to see you in the hallways. Bye.
Hey, fourth grade friends. Congratulations, you made it to the end of the school year of 2019 and 2020. I just want to say a big, big, big congratulations for finishing Beasley so strong this year. It's been a joy to get to know all of you over the last many years. A lot of you I remember from my days as a substitute teacher and extended day teacher way back when you were in first grade and SK, so the time has really flown by. This year, you have all been presented with a challenge that no other fourth grade class has had the chance to experience, and that's our remote learning process, our schooling from home. And you guys have done so much great work. We're all so proud of you, and we're really excited to see you grow through new challenges in middle school. So some things to remember in middle school: wash your gym clothes, they start to get smelly. You will have the opportunity to drink chocolate milk every day. So let's take some time and let's process that so that we're ready for chocolate milk every day. Don't drink too much. You will be presented with new challenges in middle school, just like every stage in your life. But remember, through all these new challenges, you always have each other. You always have your families. And you always have your Beasley teachers. Come visit us and talk to us about how things are going. We know that you will do great, so you should be very, very excited. This is a great time in your life. Good luck.
Hi, and congratulations to the amazing class of 2028. I am so proud of you. I'm here to wish you all the best and much success. And my one bit of advice to you is to work hard and stay kind, have fun,
and stay true to you. We'll miss you, and lots of love.